there's a certain quality to the vibe and energy that is Sodo Sopa. From the independent merchants and unique cafes to the rustic charm of a mixed income crowd. Where else can you let loose your wild side while still being a part of helping the local economy?
In this documentary, we are going to be looking at the relation between culture and gentrification in Coolhaven. As we delve into our designed area, the first thing we found out is a project that is going to be launched in 2022. It is a complex of apartments, lofts, and studios called Little C, as you can see here.
Before going on site, we did some online research that showed how the whole complex is already sold out. From the outside, it looked like an ivory tower that only middle-aged people with a very good salary has access to. And we tried to speculate the impact it might have on the community. Usually those projects make the prices of the house market go higher, and the gentrification process will then start to attire its crowd.
Head out eating and shopping and Sodo Sopa, just take a few steps and you're home. With modern styling, these lofts are sleek, sexy, and oh so Sodo Sopa. And for those very privileged few, the most private and exclusive ownership opportunities here, announcing the residences at the lofts at Sodo Sopa. It's a place to laugh, it's a place to gather, a place to mingle with people of all economic classes. And now, it's a place to live. Sodo Sopa, welcome home.
When we went to the Little C construction site itself, we realized some of the visual styles of advertising are very invasive, particularly the one involving cancer patients with the Rotterdam slogan, "Make it happen."
Many people that worked very close to the construction site actually refused to let us interview them, as they were told they were not allowed, highlighting their lack of transparency, secrecy of real estate, and scale of money invested in making sure the image of this utopic Little C isn't damaged.
As we walk around the area and talk with the neighborhood, we start to think that our negative feeling about this project might not be shared.
Further away, we managed to get a waitress at The Machinist, which is voted the best bistro of Rotterdam, to talk to us about the future of Little C, and all she said were positive things.
This gentrification will create businesses and more jobs. However, will it marginalize people as they do not have the money to buy these expensive lofts, apartments, and studio spaces? Is there going to be a community, or is it just an attraction for outsiders and Rotterdammers on the day out?
With these questions in mind, we conduct few interviews with the customers of a vegan bakery on Nieuwe Binnenweg called Heavenly Cupcakes.
All of them made a pretty positive point on gentrification and made us rethink our position.
This particular shop that we're in, Heavenly Cupcakes, really brings in a community of individuals that are looking for community also from the vegan perspective. And finding places where you can have a cup of coffee and visit and feel at ease knowing that there's products and services that can support you, that gives you a new sense of identity. And so it's probably new to this whole community around us because they walk by every day and go, oh, I see a sign vegan. What? It's not part of my family, my history. I need this. What's this? And so sometimes I've watched people daring enough to step inside and look around, and they knew what a cupcake may look like. It was like, what's this vegan cupcake? And some actually sample. So it's for all of us if we're daring enough to open up and to experience the world and see what's in our community. Yeah. This is where we run into those problems. Also where I live on the Vine Island. Four new skyscrapers within a 3-year period. And again, most of them are already sold. Very high-end, very expensive apartments, and it's drawing in people to the community that come here for various reasons, for business, for the culture, the architecture, for other opportunities and jobs nearby. In this quarter also, since Amsterdam is getting overcrowded, people have also learned that they can live in these places, enjoy Rotterdam, and then commute to work. So it's going to put new challenges on transportation systems also, coming between cities. And what you usually find is that cities, if they haven't kept pace with that, are going to run into more issues with the locals resisting a lot of this change too fast. So we have to always be in conversation with our city governments and our developers and what's happening, and ask them to try to protect as much of the culture as possible. I think Rotterdam is probably positioned better than many cities to be aware of this. We have a great mayor and a great team of commissioners that do have conversation with community members, and I do feel like we've got a better chance of this being more successful. It won't be happy for everybody. I can agree right now with anybody. If they think otherwise, let's watch and see. But it's usually uncomfortable when a lot of these changes start happening. But they're not as uncomfortable as the bigger issues of climate change and issues of the world, because migrants, we're all going to be climate migrants at some point, so we have to work with change. So that's what I would say, just overall. Understand change, try to immerse yourself into learning how you can adjust and adapt to situations. Then you'll be much better, and you'll also be better helping the community to adjust and change. Yeah.
I have mixed feelings about that. In one way, I do feel that I have a community, and that is of being a very international one, and I mean international in the sense of Dutch and everyone else, not just everyone else besides the Dutch. I find that it's very important. On the other hand, but it's maybe more of a personal thing. I never really feel that much at home anywhere, really.
But I will give you some example of the things that I noticed here coming from somewhere else about the social aspect. I'm talking about like social, what do you call it? Social equality, social. Like for example, there's a lady who comes to our place to clean every 2 weeks.
Yes.
She's an immigrant as well. She lives in Macron, yeah. She takes the subway or her husband drives her. And she's a close friend with my mother. And we spend, something that you never see in any other country, where we spend so much time. I mean, we're talking about somebody who spends 3 hours cleaning. We spent so much time, she's telling me where to go for a vacation next. She goes to Corfu for the summer job, for a summer for like 3 weeks. Fancy hotels, interesting time with her kids and husband. It's like, wow, it's like you cannot find this in any other country in the world where this level of society is enjoying life at the same time. It's like for me, I wouldn't ask for more from life, except for going on a vacation for 3 weeks. That's like the ultimate. And people who are on the bottom ladder of society, they are already enjoying it. So for me, there is no objective, like financial gain is not really an objective. My life is not gonna change, given the fact that this is what the government here, the society provides social, everybody to enjoy.
Have all this new, also technology, the agriculture, like you have very, very forward thinking companies in Rotterdam that you don't have in Amsterdam.
But I will tell you, the way after the war, some of the parts of Rotterdam were built too quickly.
Yeah.
And now they are realizing the mistakes.
Yeah. True.
And, and a lot of what you guys are searching for has to do with fixing those mistakes. I mean, I'll give you an example. St. Laurent Church. It's a prime location in any city in Europe where you have the center medieval church.
Yeah.
The area around it is the location where you see these if you go there, you will see these houses that are built quickly.
Yeah, that's true.
And there's
that's
a question mark around those now. There's got to be who lives there, what sort of rent do they pay.
Yeah.
But this is one of the, yeah, it's like you would expect something different next to the old medieval remnants.
Yes. Which is like a nuclear part, like of the whole city, because if you've been like bombed and destroyed, and you have this medieval church, that's like a big part of the city, and it's curious.
And then you put next to it the marble.
Exactly.
We came to a conclusion after all the interviews and research we did, that due to our position, lack of time, and the language barriers, we may not have complete unbiased opinions of this topic.
However, looking at the governmental policies set in place, visually seeing people of different cultures, diversity of stores coexisting, gentrification in this area has positive outcomes, and the construction of Little C will do little damage. Or at least we hope so.